So in this video, we will try to understand how to draw shear force and bending moment diagram in case of cantilever beam. In this particular case, we have to draw shear force and bending moment diagram in case of a cantilever beam of 2 meter long, and it is subjected to a uniformly distributed load of 20 kN per meter for a distance of 1.5 meter from the fixed end. So let us draw first the arrangement for this. So this is the fixed end. We are having a uniformly distributed load acting at a distance of 1.5 meter from the fixed end, and total span length is 2 meter. The uniformly distributed load UDL is of 20 kN per meter, and that is also shown over here. Now let us start with first the shear force diagram calculations. We are considering the conventions that we are having these upward forces are considered as negative, whereas downward forces, they are considered as positive. Now first we'll draw the baseline. Now as shown over here at point C, there is no force that is acting, and therefore shear force at point C will be zero. Similarly, shear force at point B will also be zero because there is no force that is acting on the right hand side of B. Now we have to find out shear force at point A. Consider all the forces which are acting on the right hand side of A. So on the right hand side of A, there is only UDL that is acting, and that is of 20 kN per meter acting for 1.5 meter length. So 20 into 1.5, so that will be 30 kN. So that is the load which is acting in the downward direction, and we have considered the downward forces as positive, and therefore let us draw the diagram using these particular values. So our first value is 0, the second value is also 0, so draw a straight line over here. So this is the straight line, then it is increasing to 30 kN. So this is 0, shear force at C is 0, shear force at B is also 0, and shear force at A is 30 kN. So this is the shear force diagram in this particular arrangement. Now let us try to draw the bending moment diagram also. So first we'll calculate these bending moments. So bending moment calculations, clockwise negative and anti-clockwise positive. These are the conventions which we have used. Start from the right hand support. So bending moment at C is 0 because there is no force that is acting on the right hand side of C. Bending moment at B is also 0 because there is no force that is acting on the right hand side of B. Now for calculation of the bending moment at A, we have to consider all the forces which are acting on the right hand side of A, and there is only UDL that is acting over a 1.5 meter length. So first we'll convert this UDL into point load. So 20 into 1.5, that is the UDL, and it will be acting at the center of 1.5 meter length. So in this way, we can convert this UDL into point load. So center means it is 1.5 divided by 2. Now this force will produce the clockwise moment, and clockwise moment we have considered as negative. So this is minus, force is 20 into 1.5 that we have written over here. So first two terms, they indicates the force, correct? The UDL which we have converted into point load, and multiplied by the perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance is 1.5 upon 2. So force multiplied by this perpendicular distance will give the moment, and that is 22.5 kN per meter negative, because the moments are clockwise, and clockwise moments we have considered as negative. Now as it is a uniformly distributed load, okay, it will have a parabolic distribution, and the magnitude of it is 22.5 kN meter, and we have drawn that below the baseline because the moment is negative. So in this way, we can draw the shear force and bending moment diagram in case of cantilever beam.